Hello kids, today we are going to do operating system and graphical user interface part 2. Last time we saw what is an operating system, what are its different functions. Today we will be seeing what are the different type of operating systems. These are the different type of operating systems: single user, multi-processing, multitasking, multi-threaded, real-time operating system and distributed operating system. We'll see each of them. First, we'll see what is a single user operating system. A single user operating system allows only one user to work with a computer at a time. Just now, if I am using the computer, then at the same time, nobody else can use the same computer, memory, CPU and the resources, even connecting remotely. Microsoft DOS, Windows 3.1, 95, all this is single user operating system. Initially, we used to use only single user operating system. It used to have limited features and nowadays they are not being used. Nowadays, we use multi-user operating system, which allows more than one user to work with a computer at same time or at different times. Like say, if you are having Windows NT, that is networking software installed, then your computer CPU, your computer memory can be used by some other person sitting in some other computer and then trying to use the hardwares of your computer. These are the different type of operating system: Unix, Linux, Windows Vista, Microsoft Windows NT. Windows 2000 was the first one to support multi-user operating system. Multiprocessor. Now what is a processor? Processor is a CPU or the brain of the computer. Now if I am having more than one microprocessors or CPU and they are using the same memory, then it becomes a multiprocessor operating system. Because I have two CPUs, the speed would be very high and the computer would be very powerful. It increases the performance of all the tasks that are done by the computer because it can execute multiple processes because I have two processors or more than one processors. Multitasking. What do you mean by multitasking? Doing more than one task at one point of time is called multitasking. A multitasking operating system is an operating system which allows various work or say various applications to run simultaneously. You can see music being played, Excel open, browser also open. All this can work simultaneously. Then it is said to be a multitasking operating system. Actually, it is not doing all the tasks together, but the operating system or the processor moves from one task to another so quickly that you feel that all the three tasks are performed simultaneously. These are the examples: Unix, Linux, Windows 7, Windows 8, etc. Okay, and all the latest Windows that we use nowadays. Different part of program are allowed to run simultaneously in multi-threaded operating system. Now normally when you are writing a code, it has only one execution happening. In a multi-threaded code, there are different codes which are running simultaneously. This kind of running can be possible with the help of multi-threaded operating system. The negative point of this is that it degrades the performance at times, because in one program it is trying to run more than one parts of that program or threads of that program, so it degrades the performance. These are the examples for it. Real-time operating system. When the time interval to process and respond to input is very small, then this RTOS is used. It handles real life scenarios, and there are two type of hard RTOS: hard real time system and soft real time systems. This is distributed operating system. Distributed operating system has many processors connected together, and operating system is distributed among all of them. They distribute their work and do simultaneously. This is distributed operating system. This is all for today. Thank you, students.